Mandy Moore says she was so lonely in marriage to Ryan Adams, "I felt like I was drowning." After opening up about her troubled marriage to Ryan Adams in a recent New York Times expose, Mandy Moore is delving even deeper into the challenges she says she faced during their relationship. The This Is a Star sat down with Marc Maron for a new episode of his WTF podcast, where she reflected on her 7-year marriage to Adams, and how she found herself living my life for him. "It was an entirely unhealthy dynamic. I had no sense of self," she shared with Maron. "I felt like I was drowning. It was so untenable and unsustainable, and it was so lonely," she added. "I was so sad. I was lonely with him." During the podcast, which was recorded before the Times expose was published, Moore said she found herself unable to work on major projects during her marriage to Adams, claiming that she only took on little jobs because she felt like her marriage would crumble any time she needed to focus on anything but their relationship. "There was a constant stream of trying to pay attention to this person who needed me and wouldn't let me do anything else," Moore said, later adding, "This wasn't the rest of my life. I knew that this wasn't the person I was supposed to be with. I knew that I wasn't the person I was meant to be." Listen to the full WTF interview with Maron to hear more from the celebrated actress, including her future plans to make music with husband Taylor Goldsmith. Her comments about her ex-husband mirror those Moore made in the New York Times article, where she accused Adams, from whom she filed for divorce in 2015, of psychological and emotional abuse. "Music was a point of control for him," the 34-year-old actress said in the report. "His controlling behavior essentially did block my ability to make new connections in the industry during a very pivotal and potentially lucrative time, my entire mid to late 20s. Adams' lawyer told The Times that Moore's allegations were completely inconsistent with his view of the relationship, and that he supported her well-deserved professional success. Since the release of the expose, which featured interviews with 7 women who accused Adams of various forms of abuse, a number of other women have come forward with similar accusations. Adams has vehemently denied any intentional wrongdoing. In the wake of the article, Adams has lost a number of lucrative endorsements and has had his upcoming album release cancelled. For more on the fallout stemming from the Times expose, watch the video below.